CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 1.5, Compare and Contrast Common Units of Measure. Storage Units. We will get to the units of measure used for storage data shortly. First, I want to address the concept of data at rest. Data at rest in information technology means data that is housed physically on a storage drive in a digital format. Now, with that concept out of the way, we can now take a look at the specific measurements used for storage. Or for that matter, data that is at rest. Storage units are measured in bytes. That is uppercase B for bytes, not lowercase b for bits. The storage unit, bytes, can measure anything from a file, a group of files, or the contents of an entire storage drive. The storage drive itself will also have a capacity measured in bytes. Anytime you have data that is not being accessed and is stored on a physical medium like a storage drive, the preferred unit of measure will be bytes. As a few bytes can only store a minimal amount of information, we will have to deal in much larger quantities of bytes to meet today's demands. Some relevant quantities are kilobytes. Kilobytes are quantities measured in thousands of bytes. This is an expected size for a text file or smaller images. We also have megabytes. Megabytes are quantities measured in millions of bytes. This is an expected size for larger images or smaller videos. Then there are gigabytes, which are quantities measured in billions of bytes. This is a common size for full-length cinematic movies, and many modern hard drives have storage capacities in this range. Now we are getting into some big storage units. Up next is terabytes. Terabytes are quantities measured in trillions of bytes. Newer hard drives are now exceeding the terabyte threshold. The last storage unit we need to know for the CompTIA ITF Plus exam is petabytes. Petabytes are quantities measured in quadrillions of bytes. You might find these units of measure in large company servers, data centers, or other places where significant quantities of data are stored. At some point, you will undoubtedly have to convert between different storage unit sizes. This chart will help a bit visually. But I will also talk you through it and hit some key points for you. First, as you study, I want you to commit the order of sizes to memory from smallest to largest. Which would be byte, kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, and petabyte. And now from largest to smallest, petabyte, terabyte, gigabyte, megabyte, kilobyte, and back to a single byte. Next, you should know that moving from any storage unit measure to the next closest measure is always a factor of 1000. Example. 1 kilobyte is 1000 bytes. 1 megabyte is 1000 kilobytes. 1 gigabyte is 1000 megabytes. 1 terabyte is 1000 gigabytes, and so on. Understanding the relationship between these storage unit sizes will assist in converting between them when needed. Before I wrap this topic up, I wanted to do at least one measurement conversion with you. For our example, we will start with 44.6 megabytes. I will now convert this to kilobytes and then gigabytes. For those of you who don't trust your math skills, no problem. The most important part is to follow the decimal point, which I will now make red. As the difference from each storage unit size to the next closest size is a factor of 1000, we will see the decimal point move three place values to the left if going up one storage unit size. Or to the right three place values if we go down one storage unit size. I will start with converting 44.6 megabytes to kilobytes. As we went down a storage unit size, we have moved the decimal point three place values to the right. Now we can see that 44.6 megabytes is equivalent to 44,600 kilobytes. Now I will convert 44.6 megabytes to gigabytes. As we went up a storage unit size, we have moved the decimal point three place values to the left. Now we can see that 44.6 megabytes is equivalent to 0.0446 gigabytes. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.